I remember when I ran into you, we was at SOB's at one of the Duck Down's more recent within the past few years events.
Yep.
And you spoke to me then about doing the gym. You know, putting the gym in Brownsville.
Yeah.
I spoke to you about the blockumentary. You know what I mean? And I'm about, I mean, whatever you need, I gotta reiterate, whatever you need. I mean, I appreciate the way you laid it all out for us. This shit sound, I mean, it's amazing, real talk.
I truly believe it start with y'all, the music. I ain't gonna lie to you, Chet, even though I'm trying to bring the visuals to light, I did a dope-ass reel, a little trailer that I can send to you guys, showing that, you know, like the crime rate in Brownsville. And I see, I was directly affected by it, Champ. You know what I'm saying? When we got kicked out the towers, I ain't had no place to stay. And me and my moms, we lived all around Brooklyn. We moved down the hill, up the hill. We stayed at my cousin's house in Van Dyke. We stayed everywhere we could. So for me, being a homeless teenager, I was this close from going to prison. I was this close from getting shot. I was so close. I made it through the crack. You know what I'm saying? So when I look back and I look at like my life, man, I'm lucky, champ. I'm not. People say I'm blessed. I'm lucky, man.
I feel the same way, man. Yo,
homeboys, man. Yo, first of all, let me just keep it 100 with y'all. I wanted to be a rapper. But I was whack. I went to a block party and these niggas burnt me. Right? And I started a fight and them niggas jumped me and I got away. I just it was with my anger because he burnt me in front of everybody on the mic. My name was S Dollar. You know what I'm saying? Then I changed the damn money. But I was homeless. Close the door, y'all. Close the door, guys.
I can't believe I never.
You ever told anybody this before?
Nah, champ. Okay, I went to a block party in East New York. And over there off Picking, right? And I was rapping, they let me rap. And I rapped, and I was whacked after them. And another nigga burnt me. And I was mad. And I started a fight, and they jumped me. I barely got away. I ran. I made it back to Brownsville. And I was like, yo, this rapping shit ain't for me, champ. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
But right. Then I met Sean. See, when I met Sean, and then him and Rock was partners, Rock voice was I said, yeah, that's what I need. I need to sound like him. I'm gonna keep it 100 with you, champ. I was mad that he was nice and rock around like that. I was never hating on him. I love my boy. But I wanted to rap like Rock. So I had to go to boxing.
Listen, a lot of people want to rap like Rock.
Right? Let me tell you this, B. Like I told you before, I wished I could box like you. Like, I'm supposed to be a heavyweight. I'm over here. Look at me all skinny over here.
I was supposed to be an MC, champ, but I ain't had it, champ.
Briggs, let me ask you this, man. Like you said, Riddick Bowe grew up under you or over you?
Upstairs.
Y'all actually knew each other?
Nah, like, I just seen him around. He was older than me. They all older than me, him and Mike.
Right.
I used to see big, tall dude, Jerry Curl, looking crazy to me. But I was like, you know what I'm saying? You know? But I was younger than them. You know, Plaza was always bad. You know what I'm saying? So,
right.
Nice to go outside of Plaza. It was always fights. I was little. Mm-hmm. But, and then we wound up moving to, now my grandmother died. When she died, like 82, 83. We didn't go over there and see my grandfather because he wasn't really my grandfather. He was my grandmother's husband. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
So we ain't really mess with him no more. Then he died, Mr. Teddy. You know what I mean? So yeah, man. But that was my Plaza days. But my family from Riverdale, Van Dyke, again Marcus Garvey, all over. You know, and boys.
Yeah.
Let me ask you this.
Oh, wait, one more, Rock. When you won the belt, how did that feel, man?
Damn, Frank.
Because, you know, Mike won it, then, you know, Riddick Bowe won it. It's like, yo, I got to win it. Like, with the pressure on you, like.
Facts. And plus, I was never supposed to be in it. To be up in that spot. You know, I was just literally, you know, sleeping on the train. Me and Mom's trying to figure it out. And then a few years later, I'm walking up the stairs to fight George Foreman. My mom's had died. My mom died on my birthday, you know what I'm saying?
I was watching. I seen this joint, man.
Yeah, and I was like, damn, you know, I was dead inside it to some degree. So that's how I was able to take it. Because when you lose your mom, you know what I'm saying, that just take a part of you, you know what I mean? So for me, I was able to go in that fight. But when I finally won it, man, it was bittersweet because, you know, my moms had died and it was, oh, Foreman really won. It was a close decision. But I felt good for the fact that here I was, a kid from Brownsville, never had nothing. I never had a name for nothing. You know, I grew up with Vic Lowe and them. My cousin Punkin, he had got killed, Punkin from Garvey. So the boosting thing wasn't my thing, you know what I'm saying? I did it, I wasn't with it, you know what I'm saying? Jail wasn't my thing. It was the jail crew. There was the, you know, I got arrested a few times, but this ain't for me. Drug dealing, I was never good at counting money that good, you know what I'm saying? So that's the good part, you know what I mean? I was never good at counting, so they didn't want me working. I used to work for this dude named King, and he came King Allah, and I messed up the money, man. He tried to beat me up. I said, this ain't for me.
Yo, and I remember that fight, right? And I remember, like, George Foreman was like 50, right?
48.
He just beat the shit out of Michael Mora.
Everybody.
Punched him on the top of the head, knocked him out. I remember this shit. It looked like a cartoon, like, bang.
Right.
Was, like, because I know if that was me, I'm like, yo, I can't let this old dude beat me. You know what I'm saying? Like,
I mean, but Foreman at the time was crazy still.
Huh?
I said Foreman at the time, though, was still out there really doing something.
I'm telling you, so was it like, yo, I can't let this nigga beat me, like this old nigga or whatever. Like, how was George? Was he really tough? Like,
it was crazy.
You was in the whole, like,
I tell people, I ain't gonna hold you, it was the first round. I never forget. I remember it. You know, I've been hitting the head a lot, but I remember this like it was yesterday, champ. I remember where I was at, because I had made a step to the left, and I seen that he didn't do good when he turned around this way. So I went, I faked that way, I went the other way again. I did it again, and he bit. You know, they said don't do the same thing twice, right?
Right.
I did it twice, and he bit. And I said, damn, he ain't peeping that. I got him beat on the turn, you know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
So I did it again, and when he went to turn, yo, I swung a hook hard as I could. Look at my knuckle, y'all.
Yeah.
I swung, and there was a little Reyes glove, and yo, watch my word to my mother. The knuckle, it went in his eye, dog. Like the Reyes glove, the leather, I said, this gonna knock his eye out. I knew it. It was a cool shot. I hit him hard as I could. It went in the eye. He ain't even blinked the eye.
Oh, man.
I said, I looked. I went back to the corner. I was like, I'm dead. I'm dead. I was like, he gonna kill me. I was thinking, and then moving, hitting him with his pad, trying to keep him off because he just kept coming. And then he hit me. What really got me, I'm gonna tell you what, two things that stuck out was that first round. The second thing was at one point when he grabbed me in the first round, he smelled like he ain't take a shower in like a month. But that was a tactic. You know what I'm saying?
That's what I'm about to say.
Yeah. But he was so musty when we got it. It got my attention. It scared me, son. You
fucking. Oh my goodness.
Bro, word of mother. Imagine you fighting somebody and they grab you and they go musty. What you gonna do?
Right.
Like pepper spray in the eyes.
You know what I'm saying? That's a weapon, yo.
What do you think your toughest fight was? Was it that Foreman fight?
I was 25 years old, champ, to be honest with you. You know what I'm saying? It was 12 rounds. Well, you know, I think the toughest fight for me was when I fought Klitschko. In the first round, my left tendon popped in my arm. They had to come through this side surgery and come through this side. That was in the first round, so I fought for 12 rounds, one arm. I took like 280 punches to the head, man. And I was banged up pretty bad, but I was still trying to get it. I was still trying to knock him out.
I lost some bread on you that day, champ.
Yeah, champ. It wasn't, man. I still popped in the first round, son, but it was like, yo, just quit. when I came back to the corner, they said, I said, yo, my arm fucked up. It was like, yo, stop the fight. I was like, nah, third, second, third, fourth. They said, yo, you getting beat up bad. By the eighth round, the referee came to the corner and I was beat up. And now mind you, on everything, y'all, on everything on Brownsville, right before the fight, I had took some Just for Men. That's why I don't got my shit no more. Yeah. I had took some Just for Men, right? And all the times I had took it, nothing really not happened. Yo, this time I had an allergic reaction before the fight. Oh. Yo, my whole face blew up. I had pus leaking on the pillow. When I would wake up, son, the whole pillowcase be wet. Yo, I had pus leaking out my face from the reaction I had, son. I was getting needles, hydrocortisone in my face, shots over in Germany. I'm waking up, I can't sleep, son. I'm just wrapping my face with towels, just trying to lay like this, thinking about how I'm gonna fight this man if I get hit in the face. This is a week and a half before the fight. I go into the fight, soon as he start hitting me, guess what happened? My face starts swelling up. So people think like, damn, you getting fucked up? But nah, it was more to it than that. I had took that shit. So wrong. Now that's happening. My arm popped. Use that door for me, champ. My arm popped. You feel me? And I'm taking a beating. But the eighth round, the referee came to the corner. He said, champ, I gotta stop it. You ain't show me. I said, nah, don't stop. I'm about to knock him out this round. I got him where I want him. That was the Brownsville bluff. That was the Brownsville bluff. But somehow I snuck a right hand in. And you look at the ninth round, I snuck a right hand in with him and I caught him, banged him, bomb, his whole leg wobbled. I couldn't come back with the hook, y'all. I landed the right hand, I did like this. I said, oh, I couldn't throw the hand. The joint in my elbow popped like this. It was hanging down. My arm was longer on this side, it was hanging down. Yeah. So I took a beating.
I'm the Rock, Miss Boston. And I'm here to let you know that I'm on Cameo now. Are you familiar with Cameo? It's a website where you can reach out to some of your favorite celebrities and have them send you shout outs, personalized, birthday wishes, wedding congratulations. You can even have them quit your job for you. And now I'm there. You can use the Cameo app or you can go on Cameo.com or the Cameo website. Find me there and make your request. We also have special requests for business, you know, if you want your mixtape dropped on or your album promote, any promotional things, special pricing for that. See us there. Rock Miss Monster on Cameo. Rock on, rock on.
Thank you for listening to Monster Mondays podcast. Please join us every Monday from 8 to 10 p.m. West Coast time and 11 to 1 a.m. East Coast time. Every single Monday, Monster Monday, on the Dash app. Also, check out these awesome shows from the rest of our podcasting family. Funny Farm, East New York Radio, All Elements Mix Show, The Star Power Collective, La Cosa Nostra Radio, 5150 Mix Show, Block News Live, Final Coffee Mix Show, and Hidden Gems. Check them all out under the Delicious Vinyl on Radio Station.